Alright, I'm gonna just show you guys what I'm doing with my setup and stuff real quick. Cause I gotta set up my rods. This string hasn't been used since like the 1980s on this reel, so. Let's see how that goes. Anyways, if you don't know how to set up a pole, which I'm pretty sure you should now, just take this little piece here. A lot of the times you just unscrew it right here. That bad boy on there. Let's screw right back on. Flip your bell over. I'm gonna thread it all the way up. Simple uni knot. We don't have to get too crazy. Just thread it. I usually thread it like this because I feel my line to feel if it has, I feel my line to feel if it has any kinks or anything in it. That's a good line right there. All right. Like this. With your tag in, make a loop. Grab with your fingers. And with these up here, just twist it around. Just twist these bad boys around. Just twist these bad boys around. Twist these bad boys around. And just pull it tightly. Of course, get ready to tag in. Just tag in. This water just don't look like it used to. Literally, a bass just hit it right there. Came off though. I don't know why I hit most of my bass like right next to the bank when I'm reeling it in, but. That's why I never ever give up on reeling. Oh, that's a nice one. Oh, he came off. Son of a biscuit. Damn, that was a nice bass. There he is. At least, not the same one, but I got one. A little small guy. Tinkerbell. First one that hit it though. That first one was the pops. Oh man, there was another one. What the fudge? I That was a whole nother one. They must be going crazy in this cove. Going crazy. I need the pops though. I knew there was more over there. Da-da-da-da-da. It's not too bad. I just caught a bass by just taking my plopper and running it around this bridge thing that they built. Dock. I said bridge thing. Dock. They built.